Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In this video, we are going to study that what is a resistance, how we can define it, and what are the ways in which the resistance can be expressed, and what are the factors on which the resistance depends. So let us start with our topic. Resistance is the property of a material which opposes the flow of current through the conductor. Okay, means if we are having an electrical network, and in that electrical network a material or a conductor is connected. Now this conductor, there will be a flow of current in the electrical circuit, so it is the property of the material which is connected in the network that which opposes the flow of current through that material. So we can define the resistance as the property which opposes the flow of current. Now this resistance, if we want to measure the resistance, then this resistance can be calculated with the help of the Ohm's law. So according to Ohm's law, the resistance is defined as suppose V is the voltage across that material which is connected in the electrical circuit, and I is the current flowing through it. So resistance is defined as the division of the voltage and the current when the temperature is kept as when the temperature is treated as a constant property. Okay, so this formula is defined, means this Ohm's law is valid only when we consider temperature as constant. So this resistance, through this expression or through the Ohm's law, we can calculate the resistance by dividing the voltage and the current. Now when the temperature it is not treated as a constant entity, then the resistance can be calculated as so when temperature is not constant, then suppose T1 is the initial temperature and T2 is the final temperature. At T1 we have the resistance as R1 and at T2 we are having the resistance as R2. Okay, then this resistance R2, or we can say the change in the resistance, we can calculate by the formula R2 equals to R1 1 plus alpha T2 minus T1. Okay, so R1 is the initial resistance of the material at the temperature T1 degree Celsius, and when the temperature is changing, the resistance will also change. So suppose that after the temperature T2 degree Celsius, the resistance of the material is R2. So R2 can be calculated as R2 equals to R1 1 plus alpha T2 minus T1. Now this T2 minus T1, it can be written as T, which is the difference in the temperature, and alpha is the temperature coefficient of the material. Okay, so one of the formula for calculating the resistance was through the Ohm's law, R equals to V by I. Another formula, if we want that if the temperature is not taken as constant, we can calculate the resistance by using this formula. Now there is another formula for through which we can calculate the resistance. And in that formula, we are expressing the resistance in terms of the physical dimensions of the material. So the formula is R equals to rho L by A, where rho is the resistivity of the material, L is the length of the material, and A is the cross-sectional area of that material. So according to that formula, R is equals to rho L by A. Okay, this is the formula. Now in this formula, rho is the resistivity. Or we can say it is the specific resistance. L is the length of the material and A is the area. So through that formula, you can see that R is directly proportional to the resistivity. R is also directly proportional to the length of the conductor, and also R is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. So the formula becomes R equals to rho L by A. So as the specific resistance or the length of the material increases, the resistance also increases, and if the cross-sectional area increases, the resistance decreases. Okay. Now the resistance, it can be because these are the formulas through which we can calculate the resistance. So the unit of measurement of this resistance is ohms. So if we want to measure the resistance, it is measured, or the unit of measurement of resistance is ohms. So suppose the resistance of a material is 2, the value is, the numerical value is 2, so we are going to express this like 2 ohms. This is the symbol for the ohm. Now this value can be ohms, kilo ohms, mega ohms, okay. In this way we can have the different values of resistance for different materials. Now, if we want that we have a good resistance, then there are some properties which are desirable in the material which through which the resistor is, or the resistance is constructed. So what are these properties? Let's see. So the properties are that the value of the resistance should not change with time. Okay, like if we are given that this resistance is of the value 2 ohms, so the value of that resistor should not change with time. Like if the resistance is not in use for a long period, its value degrades. So this should not happen if we want that our resistor should be of good quality. Now also the resistor should have low temperature coefficient of resistance. Okay. Also, the resistivity should be high so that the size of the resistor is small. Okay, because if resistivity is high, then the resistance is high and the size of that resistance becomes smaller. Also, the properties are like the material of that resistance resistor, like the material which we are using for making the resistor, it should have a resistance to oxidation, corrosion and the moisture effects, so that the resistor do not get damaged due to these factors. Also, the material should have low thermoelectric EMF against copper. So these are the properties which are desirable for the material which we are using for making a good resistor. Okay. Now there is no single material which can have all these properties. So we use the resistor according to the application. Like for any application, if we want that this property, low temperature coefficient of resistance is requirable. So we are going to use that material which is having low temperature coefficient of resistance. Okay. So according to application, we will choose the resistance for that particular function. Okay. Now, as I have told that this resistance, it is measured in terms of ohms. So the value of the resistance, it can vary from few ohms to several mega ohms. And this resistance, it is used as the most basic element of the electrical and the electronics engineering. And for the measurement of this resistance, we have various devices, various methods are used for the measurement of the resistance. Devices like we can use multimeter for the measurement of resistance. In the multimeter, we have the two connecting leads. So we are going to place the two leads across the two ends of the resistor. The resistor, it comes in the shape of this. We have several lines over this resistor. There are different colors of the resistor, and these four bands on the resistor, they are used for calculating the value of the resistance. Okay, there is a specific formula for calculating the value of that resistance. So to measure the value of that resistance, we can use multimeter. The multimeter, they can be like analog multimeters or digital multimeters, and there are various methods also which are used for the measurement of the resistance. So in this video, we studied that what is a resistance, how it is expressed. We see different formulas, R equals to V by A according to the Ohm's law. Then R equals to rho L by A, which is expressed in terms of the physical dimensions of the material. And also we express the resistance that if we can calculate it, R2 equals to R1, 1 plus alpha T. Like if the temperature is not constant, then we can use this formula. And what is the unit of measurement of the resistance? That is Ohms. So I hope that this topic, what is a resistance, is clear to you. Thank you.